Good afternoon. I want to welcome you to the next in our series of webinars presented by CUES. My name is Brian Weitzel. I am part of the marketing team at CUES, and I'll be your host today. Today's topic is digital side scanning technology, increased production, and return on investment. In a minute, I will be introducing our speaker, but I would like to review the agenda. The presentation will be approximately 45 minutes. After the first few slides, we will be conducting a brief three-question poll to help us get to know you and better tailor the rest of our presentation. At the end, we will have about 10 to 15 minutes for some Q&A. If you have a question at any time throughout the presentation, please use the Q&A box at the bottom of your screen to type it in. At the end, I will be reading your questions to Matt and then give him a chance to answer. We will do our best to get to all questions asked. Without further ado, I would like to introduce our speaker for today's presentation, Matt Olson.
Thanks, Brian. I appreciate all of you joining us today for the webinar. My name's Matt Olson, and I'm the Southwest Regional Sales Manager for CUES. I've been with CUES for just over 8.5 years. Before I was a part of CUES, I had a background in aerospace engineering. I worked on the space shuttle and the Boeing 787. So as Brian said, we're talking about digital side scanning today. So the agenda for the presentation is, why is a better inspection method needed? So we'll cover, traditional methods and then how digital side scanning fits within our industry with traditional methods. We'll talk about four key challenges that we have found while working with a lot of our customers. There's consistent issues that people have in the field within the organizations, in the office, in the field. So we'll review those. We will do a deeper dive into what digital side scanning technology is, how it works, our product, the DUC system, the digital universal camera, how it works with software. Then we'll review a case study we did with the city of Tampa. So they went through and have digital side scanning trucks, DUC trucks. And then they have the traditional pan and tilt analog camera systems. And we did a several month study with them to figure out how those are used and the savings they got out of it, the time in the field. And then we'll review the four challenges that we talk in section two here and how those issues are solved with having a combination of your analog TV, and then also incorporating digital side scanning technology. And then we'll review some facts about, just common questions that come up. So why is a better method needed than our traditional pan and tilt inspection method? So there's 800,000 miles of public sewer in the US, an incredible fact about that. That's enough pipe, just sewer pipe, to wrap around the earth 32 times. Whenever I put it in that perspective, it just amazes me how much underground sewer there is in the US. The US, the infrastructure report card from the American Society of Civil Engineers is a D+. So we have a lot of room to grow. We have a lot of good stuff going on in the country, a lot of strong organizations performing excellent work. But just because of the age of the infrastructure, and how it was built, how it's maintained, we have a lot of work to do. There's going to be 56 million new users in the next two decades attaching to our sewer system. So not only do we have a lot of work to do with the current infrastructure, we're going to be adding infrastructure, and we need to get ahead of the game with this. So getting ahead of aging and failing infrastructure, and so digital side scanning is here to enable us, to get that score up, get ahead of the game, get more pipes inspected in timely fashion. This inspection method and camera system and software system isn't meant to completely replace the analog pan and tilt, right? And we'll talk about that multiple times during the presentation and where this really fits. But it'll definitely help, the United States and all over the world get ahead of the game with producing more efficient, more accurate inspections. So four key challenges that we notice the majority of organizations facing when managing these underground assets. So labor resources is obviously one of them. Just lack of available labor in the trenchless industry. Operational cost. So increased cost of labor, increased cost of maintenance on equipment and traditional methods obviously have a lot more operational cost, and we'll cover why that is, than digital side scanning. Accurate and historical records. So lack of historical data for pipeline inspections for future use. So did we inspect this line already? Did we pan and tilt in the right direction and see everything within the pipe? Did we code it correctly? Is it easy to review? And then making informed decisions from that. So, inability to make decisions due to improper, incomplete inspections. So everybody has their own unique set of challenges. These are just four common ones that I think everybody here can relate to. And throughout this presentation, we'll address all of these challenges. So what is digital side scanning technology? It is a fisheye 360 degree view of the pipe. So you're seeing the entire pipe. It's high definition, right? So it's typically four times higher resolution than your standard analog pan and tilt camera. There's no moving parts, right? Which is gonna help reduce repair cost. And then you inspect without stopping as well. So that's gonna increase your speed of inspection. But since you're not having to pan and tilt as you go through the pipe, you could just set the transporter in cruise control and let it run the entire length of the pipe. Here's a comparison in between when I talk about traditional analog inspection. I'm talking about the camera on the left here. This is our Oz 2 camera. On the right is our duck camera, digital universal camera. This is used for digital side scanning. Point out a couple of differences here. You could see on the left, you have pan and tilt. On the right is the fisheye. So no moving parts. No moving parts makes it easier to seal. You don't have the extra motors in the camera. So you're gonna have less wear and repair and cost on those items. You can also see that the lighting is a little bit different in the picture on the left with our Oz camera. You could see the four either incandescent or LED lights. On the right, you could see that we have LED lights as well, but they're distributed around the camera head. Some have a clear lens in front of it. Some are fogged. That's used for distribution of light throughout the pipe to balance it. You can also control it via the software. Those are the main differences that you can see in these two different cameras. Similarities are you're going to be using the same transporters. So our duck system uses the same exact transporters that our Oz 2 uses. All right, so digital side scanning is a proven inspection method. It's fairly new technology to the industry. It's been around for almost a decade now, since 2012. Most customers really started coming on board in about 2014. So it's considered new by most, but it is tried and true and a lot of experience out in the field. It's also been a chosen leading and innovative technology at most major trade shows like the WET Show. So it is recognized and known in the industry as a plausible way to get ahead of the game and inspect your pipe. A couple other points about it, 4 times to 8 times resolution increase over traditional. Reminder, traditional is the pan and tilt cameras. Full 360 degree capture of the entire pipe without panning and tilting. So no more reviewing video, wishing you could have seen what was over on the left when you're looking at something on the right. It's going to capture everything. And we'll go over what that looks like and how we use that in future slides here. Zero moving parts like we talked about before. That is just, talking about sealing a camera, talking about pan and tilt motors, talking about having slip ring technology in there. We avoid all that kind of stuff by being able to capture it just in one photo. and not having to look around. And then you also, another serious advantage that we'll move into now is, or move into in future slides, is the three different unique views of the pipe. You're no longer just watching a video inside the pipe. You're going to be having flat images and able to scan through the pipe very quickly and look for observations. So the four steps to digital side scanning, you're going to set up, you know, you're going to do your traffic control, you're going to do your gas mitigation and gas detection, opening the manholes, all that kind of stuff, set up the same that you're going to be doing with your traditional analog pan and tilt cameras. Then you're going to put the transporter in the pipe and run it. And this is where things change a little bit. So as you can see in step two here, we're just cruising through a PVC pipe. We normally recommend that you clean the pipe beforehand. It doesn't necessarily have to be clean, but the people that are most successful or the organizations that are most successful with this type of work are setting up a game plan of the pipes they're going to inspect that they know are going to have major obstructions, and then have a plan to clean beforehand, right? So I want to focus on this a little bit because it's a slight paradigm shift. Step two and step three are a slight paradigm shift than the way we typically operate with normal analog pan and tilt cameras. And the people that are most successful have a project and a plan based around digital side scanning, right? So they will pick, say, a basin six. They know it has a lot of 8, 10, 12 inch. We can do significantly larger than that. But this helps get the mindset in there. You pick a basin that you know you're going to clean ahead of time and that you can just set the transporter in cruise control and drive through the pipe and just be collecting data the whole time. You know, take out the whole cable length, 1,000, 1,500, 2,000 feet of cable, you know, in one setup. That's really going to reduce the amount of time that you spend in the pipe, right? And as you notice in step two, you're not panning and tilting and moving around. The other part of the paradigm shift in using this camera that people are the most successful with is how you code it, right? And we'll go through a lot of examples throughout this presentation on coding, but you're not doing it as you're in the pipe. So step three here is after completion of the pipe, the operator will sit there and code, you know, all the different observations that they see within the pipe. And this can be done in many different ways, right? This can be done, you know, as you're breaking down the equipment in your setup, right? Say you run 3-4 different segments in one setup. As one of the operators is cleaning the equipment, pulling out of the pipe, the other operator inside the truck can be coding and completing those inspections. You can do it when you get back to the field. So when you're doing cleanup at the end of the day, you can code all of the lines that you did throughout the day. You can do it where you have someone internally in the office that you download all of this data to, and you have one dedicated person in the office that's coding these. You can do it at the end of the week. So there's a lot of different ways to do it, and whatever fits best within your organization, you can do. But it's not the same way when, see, you're pulling up to this lateral, looking at step two, you're pulling up, you pan and tilt and look at the lateral, you do your code, and then you straighten out the camera and you keep driving. You don't have to do that with digital side scanning. In step four here, right, with our GNet software that works with the digital camera, you can connect it with Esri. And as if you don't have experience with Esri here, you can actually code, or you can actually set layers on these maps to where, depending on what code you have entered into these lines, it'll have different colors like your yellows, your oranges, your greens, your reds that you see here, right? So that's the full picture of the step-by-step process here, right? Set up like normal, run through the pipe on cruise control, code when you're not out in the field using traffic control, right? Reducing operation costs. Step four, you're uploading it to your GIS and saving this complete inspection. So understanding digital side scanning technology, the flat images are the cornerstone to capturing all the data, understanding it, looking at it, you know, covering a lot of these different challenges that we brought up in previous slides. So what a flat image is you're taking a picture, a 360 degree picture of the pipe, right? So you're capturing all of this, you're cutting the pipe or you're cutting the picture, and then you're gonna roll this picture out and stitch them all together. And so you're gonna get what you see in the top here, right? And as you can see, this is the bottom pipe 6 o'clock position. Our software allows you to cut this at whatever makes sense to you. The majority of the people cut it at the 6 o'clock position, and you can see that it gives you the best picture of the pipe that's unobstructed by the water in the pipe in the center of your picture here. As you can see, this is the bottom where the water is. Once you cut it out, obviously half's gonna be on this side, half's gonna be on this side. It's exactly what we're seeing here. Half the water there, half the water here. This is, you know, 12 o'clock position of your pipe. So cut down the middle, stitch all together, and that's gonna give you a clear view of the entirety of your pipe. All right, so with the flat images, it's gonna give you a quicker review, and you'll see that as we go through, and obviously we have some data from that from our case studies. I'm gonna run you through some inspections of, you know, 10 inch, 12 inch, 8 inch pipe and show you exactly what you would be seeing if you would be coating this stuff after the inspection, right? You can detect the smallest of defects because you have 4 to 8 times the actual resolution. You're never going to be missing an observation because you're collecting the entirety of the pipe, right? In our camera, we take 4 HD images, 3.1 megapixels images every second. So you're getting a lot of clarity there, and it's giving you the ability to pan and tilt within it and zoom in on these pictures as well. All right, the 3 unique views of the flat images. We have the multi-flat, we have the flat view, and we have the video view. So traditionally, you only have the video view when you're doing analog pan and tilt. This one gives you the multi-flat, so you can get an idea of, you know, longer distance into the pipe. You can easily see in this photo here, you know, you got a tap here, you got a tap here. One thing I also want to point out here is notice the red line on this tap that's associated with this red line here. So you'll see in future slides, we will just click on this point. But this flat or the multi-flat, this flat, and then the video view are always synced up with each other. So if I click any point of this multi-flat, it'll take me there in the main flat image. And then it'll also take me there in the video. So red line associated there, associated here, associated here. All right, we also talked about rapid assessment. So using the flat view, you're easily able to identify, you know, the different points of your observations. So we have a tool within our software called the multi-select tool. So you just click the multi-select like we did just a second ago, and you can go and jump to any lateral there, any similar observation that you have throughout it. This would be laterals or taps. And we're just selecting all the different taps. Notice we haven't entered a code. We haven't done anything yet. We're just saying multi-select, and we're clicking on where all the taps are. Notice how we're going through the multi-flat view. It's going to take us to that in the flat view and also the video. Still just selecting all the similar observations that we're going to have here, have not entered an observation yet. Now we are actually going to create the observations. Entering our code. You notice there all of the clock, and you'll get a better view of this on another page, but all your footage and clock positions are tracked as you use the multi-select tool. You can go through and click on the different observations, and it'll take you to that exact point in the multi-flat, the flat, and the video view. So once again, this is the multi-select tool. You can already see here, compared to traditional methods of adding observations, this can significantly reduce error and time spent coding. Another thing that we don't talk about in this presentation, but is a good thing to mention at this point, is we have also a hotkey function within our GNet software. So as they went through and actually entered in a code, you can create a hotkey like control T for tap that allows you to reduce time even more entering these observations. All right, different user-friendly tools. We talked about how using the multi-selector, it gave us clock position. As you can notice on the left-hand side, there's clock position, and there's also a distance position indicator. On these future slides, a couple slides ahead of this, I'll have a closer up view for you to be able to see this. This gives you a bigger picture of where this all sits in within your screen. So we have the clock position, we have the distance, we have a grid that you can turn on. We actually have a measurement tool. You can measure crack lengths. You can measure tap diameters. You can do a built-in, or sorry, a 360 joint scan. Notice how he's using it on the flat and it's taking the image from the video and doing an easy joint scan. You can change your size of your multi-flat. You can enhance the size of the flat. Another thing you can do is the virtual pan and tilt and zoom on your video image. So since this is 3.1 megapixel images, you have a lot of pixels there to be able to zoom in on and see with a lot of clarity. All right, now we're going to go through three different types of inspections. And see what it's like to actually code it. So this is a 10-inch PVC, 380 feet. It takes about 2 minutes here to code. So just like we saw before, we're doing our multi-select tool. We're going to select all of the similar observations. Now we're going to enter our code. Lateral. Saving it. As you notice on the right there in the video image, we actually took a picture of it. You can set it up in the GNet software to anytime you enter a code, it'll automatically take a picture for you. Showing us doing a 3D scan here. Creating an observation with the joint separation. You notice that they just drew a box over it. Now we're going back to the multi-flat. We're going to look for anything else that's standing out in the multi-flat. We're going to click on it. We're going to, you know, pan, tilt, zoom in the video image to get a better idea of exactly what it is. That one happens to just be cockroaches. So that's it. That's the amount of time it took to inspect or create the codes for a 380-foot line. We'll go through another example here. This gives you a better visual. Let me go back up here. This gives you a better visual, just bigger screen to be able to look at it on. You can see, you know, the different clock positions there on the left. We got our clock positions. We have our distance here. Using the multi-select tool right now to be able to put in our lateral inspections. Once again, like I said before, the red line here associates with the red line here, which is exactly where your video is going to be here. If you take your video there, it'll take your flat image and your multi-flat. If you take just your flat image there, your multi-flat and your video will follow. These are all synced together. Live connection, save, took a picture of the observation with that one click. List of observations, you can see all the different ones with its distance. If we scrolled over here, you'd be able to see clocking position on there as well. Now this is a 12-inch concrete, 486-foot pipe. Took 1 minute to code. This next one's an 8-inch VCP, 248 feet. It's gonna take about 3 minutes here to code. Multi-select tool. See the common thing here, right? You always go knock out these easy observations first. Multi-select tool's going through and you're picking out all your laterals. This is real time. Creating the observation, lateral, live connections, saved, all took pictures. Noticing some build up here on the pipe. Noticing a crack in the pipe. Go ahead and code the crack. You can see how they built the box around it to capture the entire length and radial of the crack. Easily identify sags by the water line coming into the picture more. Instead of starting and stopping your code for grease buildup or cracks or your sags, you just select the entire distance that it is on the pipe. And it'll automatically capture the distance. Verifying some joints here. So you can see this took about 3 minutes to code, 250 foot of pipe. And it had a little bit of everything, right? It had some cracks in there, it had some grease in there, Had a sag in there. It had all your laterals. Very simple to get through, a lot easier and a lot more efficient than you're doing with your analog pan and tilt, right? So a review of the software here, unmatched ease of use, right? Your three different views that you get from it, the multi-flat, the flat, the video view, the one-click observation coding, right? Even for all the people out there that have done the traditional method, they know when you come into a sag or grease and stuff like that, you start your code at one spot when you run into it, but you don't know how far it's going to go. So you keep driving through the pipe as you're making your other codes. And then once you get to the end of it, you have to remember to close that code for the grease or the sag. This gives you an excellent, easy, quick visual of what it is, a couple of clicks, and then you can code exactly the length and severity of those types of observations. There's no, at least for the digital sides or the digital universal camera that CUES offers, there's no camera software calibration required. You could do highly detailed and custom reporting. You could do reporting with all the pictures. You can do reports of the flats, several different ways to get all the visuals that you want. You could build it to however you want to do it with the data that we have or that you have. This is NASCO certified. And with the GNET software, you can also do bi-directional Esri integration. So you can talk to and listen to Esri, uploading, downloading information. And like with all of our products, the industry leading technical support, all in-house in the United States, and all of our partnerships with CityWorks, Esri, IBM Maxo, Hanson, Lucidy, all with our GNET software here. So whatever types of programs you use, we typically have a good interface with them. Now on to the case study. So this is obviously a proven technology. We've had a lot of municipalities using it. We worked with City of Tampa very closely to study their different work because they had a good set of digital trucks, digital universal camera trucks, and traditional analog pan and tilt trucks. Tampa has about 1,800 miles and 30,000 manholes. Big picture view, they noticed 2.2 times more footage per day with the duck. So they have been able to sustain increased production all while collecting higher quality pipeline data. So you can go through here and go the different months, and digital side scanning is the blue bar, traditional pan and tilt is the gray bar. One thing to consider with this too, like I said before, this digital side scanning is not going to just take over the industry and be the end all be all and that's all you use, right? Like I talked about before in one of the earlier slides, you're using this as supplementary and driving the different sections of your system that you know you can get into and you know you can drive through, and you're cleaning ahead of time and planning ahead of time. That's where you're going to get your most production. You can use it in different manners as well, but you're going to be keeping your analog pan and tilt cameras around for, say there's an emergency come up, say that you're watching cleaning operations, say there was a collapsed pipe that you need to go find out exactly where it's at. Those aren't places that you're going to be using digital side scanning technology for, right? We're trying to get ahead of the game to make sure we have our entire system inspected every 5 to 7 years, and every municipality has those sections that they can use a system like this in. Some municipalities have more, some have less, but everybody has at least multiple sections or multiple basins that this will be a successful product in. Right, and so I bring that up as well because, you know, some of these numbers, it might look crazy to say in month 7, you know, we have almost 3 times as much production out of the side scanning. Maybe that's because some of the analog was used just doing, you know, the emergency basis. But this really shows you they had a plan going in there, and we consistently saw more production out of the digital universal camera than we did normal analog pan and tilt. So less time in the field, per foot inspected, obviously reduced support costs, right? Reduced labor costs, reduced traffic control cost, less repair because of no moving parts is going to reduce operational cost, and time that you actually spend within the pipe goes down, reducing operational costs as well. So with all those things considered, you know, we talked about at the beginning, labor resources being a challenge, and operational costs and budgets being a challenge. City of Tampa, through this study, found a 55% reduction in operational cost by using the duck camera versus traditional pan and tilt. So for what that worked out to be for them, for every 100,000 feet inspected, they saved around $26,000 in operational costs, which is significant, right? When you get into some large municipalities like Tampa that have a lot of footage out there, $26,000 is a significant amount of money. So if you were to average 1,000 feet per day over the average of 250 working days per year, this would equal $65,000 in savings annually. I mean, that's a salary right there, right? So that addresses a couple of those different challenges that we had talked about before. And this is proven via using it in the field. Talking about time savings here. So you could see, obviously, the setup's going to be the same getting into the pipe. But you could see by cruising through the pipe, on setting the transporter on cruise control and letting it go through the pipe, and then even the way to code is significantly faster than with traditional, right? And so through this study, they did a 400-foot section of 8-inch vetrified clay pipe, 20 total defects. This graph here shows time in pipe, 12 minutes versus 30 minutes, right? That's because you're set on cruise control. Time to code, 5 minutes versus 20 minutes, right? That's because you could do the different flat images, you can do the multi-select tool, you can do the measuring. You don't have to start stop defects. Total time, 17 minutes versus 50 minutes. Going back to the four key challenges. So we talked about before with labor resources, right? This allows for rapid infield data collection. And we found through the Tampa study 2.2 times production, right? One thing I can't stress enough though is in order to get increased production, you have to have a plan and adhere to some sort of shift in the way you operate your CCTV program, right? You need to set up and identify the areas that you need to go to. You need to have a plan on how you're going to code. You need to have a plan on, you know, when you're using this duck versus analog. It can't just be a decision when you show up to the pipe. Operational costs. We already talked about, you know, reduced time per pipe, right? We showed the $26,000 in savings per 100,000 feet with the city of Tampa, right? Reduction in repair cost because you don't have the pan and tilt. You don't have to seal it and deal with the cost of motors. Right? Less time coding, right? Less time paid per code or time coding per segment. Accurate records. As you could see in those flats that we're showing you, we're capturing the entirety of the pipe, right? We're no longer missing any sort of observations because say there's three or four in one section, a lot going on, you drive past it, you don't pan and tilt. Everybody's had those situations where they're watching those videos and they're turning their head, trying to look the other direction. This captures everything within there, right? And then you combine that with the coding and capturing the information in the GNet software and uploading it to Esri, you get an easy and very concise user-friendly view of all of your data out there. And with that, you can make more informed decisions. You know, anybody reviewing this, even with the codes already entered, is going to have all the data themselves as well, right? Even with the, including all the different layers that we were talking about that you can show in the Esri interface, seeing where the pipes are that need the most attention, right? You can have a lot of trust and faith in the data collected here because of the technology and the software. So frequently asked questions. What happens when you go underwater? You could see in this picture here, obviously it's going to obstruct your view just like you do when you have analog pan and tilt cameras, right? There are some, we designed our camera head so it would be, so the debris and everything could be or slide off a lot easier because it's more of a rounded lens cover, right? With your analog pan and tilt camera, it's a flat or more flat surface, right? And has some seals and everything in there. So it has more opportunity for things to get stuck. Although you can pan and tilt away from some of the debris, you can't get away from all of it. There are definitely some techniques in the field that we teach operators to reduce, you know, the amount of debris or cobwebs or grease, stuff that gets caught on the lens. It will take out, obviously, you could see in here, it'll take out some of the flat image and some of what you see, but that's, you know, typically what you're getting out of analog pan and tilt anyways. Can you see into lateral connections? Obviously, you can see from this video here, you can very easily see into lateral connections. Obviously, as the majority of you or the majority of people on here have been in plenty of pipes, they can look at this picture and know that we are going against the flow with this just because of the direction the lateral is coming. So when you're going against the flow, you can see as much as you want to see, as much as you would just with a pan and tilt camera head in there. If you're going with the flow, you know, you're going to have a reduction in what you can see up there. It's generally about 50% of the connection you can see, typically enough to determine whether it's live or capped. This is a mainline inspection system. You can see everything that you need to see to be able to perform the inspection per NASCO standards. Does the pipe have to be clean? Like I said before, your best opportunity for success at increased production and reduction in operational cost and accuracy of data is if you clean the pipes beforehand, right? We understand that these are sewer systems and something can happen in between a couple of days or weeks before or after cleaning and before you inspect. So things do happen. This doesn't have to be a perfectly clean pipe. These are using the same transporters as we do our other camera systems that go through the toughest conditions, right? So you're able to get through it, but to get the most accurate data and have set yourself up the best for success, we recommend cleaning beforehand. And it doesn't have to be perfect cleaning, right? We've seen multiple inspections, including this picture here, with a lot of with grease buildup or calcium in there. You're going to be able to see that stuff. You just want to make sure that there isn't a backup in the pipe. You're going to be able to cruise control through it. There's not going to be levels of flow that are, you know, 50, 60% where you're not going to be able to see anything, whichever camera method you use, right? Just get ahead of the game with that. Any calibration required? There are some systems out there that require calibration. Like I said before, with our software, this camera does not need any calibration to work before it goes in the pipe. Different pipe ranges we can expect. 6-inch to 60-inch pipe sizes here. So we could put it on the steerable pipe range or put a lift on there. That's how we get up into those larger pipe ranges, right? We use the ultra shorty or steerable pipe ranger for the smaller diameters as well. What speed can you inspect? So generally 8-inch pipe, 35 feet to 40 feet per minute. You know, if you're following your NASCO guidelines or if you're not doing NASCO, you know, you're going around the 35, 40 feet per minute. You can increase with larger diameter, but usually that's a safe bet of getting through the pipe successfully. Pan tilting and zooming, as we showed on previous slides, yes, you can pan, tilt, and zoom. It's got a 40-to-1 zoom ratio. You pan and tilt optic and zoom optically, and we have the ability to do that because it's such a high pixel count and such a high definition image. Does it require a dedicated transporter? No, our system, the duck camera, does not require a dedicated transporter. Doesn't require a dedicated cable. We run off of our Summit system, K2 system, gold cable, same reel. If you have an existing unit that has the gold cable, the reel, the K2 system and everything, we would need to make it duck ready for you to put this on there. What duck ready means is we have, you know, a couple communication boxes, a slip ring, a cable end, very minimal stuff that would need to go into it. Either a CUES personnel or a dealer network would help set up a quote for that, get you to understand everything that you need. But it was very important to us that we provide this functionality with minimal extras needed for it. You don't need a dedicated truck for it. Everybody out there that can run a duck camera can run any of our other stuff that we have. Can you identify a sag? You can identify a sag a lot easier and a lot faster with the duck than anything else, right? As you could see that we did before, you can see exactly where it starts to creep in, the footage that it's at, the clocking position that it goes to. You can throw the grid up there and get really detailed into what your sag is looking like, as we showed in that previous inspection. Do I need a dedicated data person? That question comes up often. I did mention before with the paradigm shift, you can have one that is dedicated to reviewing your data and you have one person that's an expert on it. That's not how everybody does it, and that's not a requirement. The majority of people at the end of the day or the end of the week on the truck do all of the coding, right? There's several different ways to do this. It really is just flexible to the program you want to run and the personnel that you have available for this. So in summary, excellent return on investment, right? We talked about the reduction in field time. We talked about reduction in operational cost. We showed you examples of that with the city of Tampa. You get 4 to 8 times the resolution increase. This allows you to see the smallest defects, but it also allows the system to act the way that it does by digitally panning, tilting, and zooming. You get a comprehensive look of your entire pipeline, right? This helps you make decisions. This gives you confidence that you captured everything. It'll be able to compare over the years of your inspections, the changes in your pipes. Zero moving parts equals limited maintenance. And then, as we've seen in many places that have committed to a strong program, 2 times increase in production. So that's the end of my presentation. I'm gonna hand it back here to Brian. I appreciate you all spending the time with me here, and I'll be available to answer any questions.
Okay, great. Thank you, Matt. Appreciate your time.
And my contact information is on this slide as well. You can send me a text, call me, email me, whatever way is your preferred method of getting a hold of me. And if I can't answer your question, I'll get you in the right hands of someone that can. And then if, you know, I'll get you in touch with your sales organization as well if it's outside of my territory.
And that about wraps up our webinar. I'm sorry if we did not get to all of your questions, but I did make note of all of the questions and they will be sent directly to Matt. We want to thank you all for attending today and hope you found value in our presentation. If you have any further questions or would like to talk to someone from CUES regarding digital side scanning technology, please feel free to reach out directly to Matt Olson. As mentioned, his contact details are on your screen, or you can always visit the CUES website for more information. If you'd like to listen to this webinar again or other CUES webinars we have presented in the past, please go to the webinar section of the CUES website and scroll down to On Demand. Today's webinar will be available within the next week. Also, if you are interested in attending future live CUES webinars, we will be updating our website with more as we schedule them. Our goal is to host one per month. And once again, thank you all for attending today's presentation.